Hello everyone, how are you all? Hope you all are safe and fine at your home. Welcome back to our maths class. Today we are moving to our next chapter, chapter number 4, subtraction. In the previous class we had studied about the addition and now we are moving to our next operation, that is subtraction. Okay, so shall we start? Okay, then what do you mean by subtraction? Subtraction means taking away a number or quantity from a given number or quantity. Okay, what does mean by subtraction? It is the taking away of a number or a quantity from a given number or quantity is called subtraction. It is the process of taking away. We are taking away something. Okay, for example, in my hand, I have got 5 balls in my hand. Okay, I have got 5 balls in my hand. And I gave the 3 balls. Okay, I gave 3 balls to one of my friend. I have given the 3 balls to one of my friend. Okay, so firstly, I have got 5 balls in my hand and I have given 3 balls to my friend. So then after giving 3 balls, how many balls are left with me? Here, it's 1 and 2. There are 2 balls left with me. Okay, so this process of taking away something is called subtraction. Okay, and the symbol of subtraction, which symbol we are using for subtraction? We are using minus symbol. Okay, so now let's write these in figures. Here firstly, I have got 5 balls and I have given 3 balls to my friend, right? Given 3 balls. So how we are writing? It's 5 minus 3. We have used the symbol of subtraction. We have subtracted 3 from 5. So 5 minus 3. So after taking away 3, what is the answer we got? This is equal to, what is the answer we got? 1, 2. There was 2 balls left, right? So the answer is 2. Okay, so 5 minus 3 equals to 2. Okay, so here the answer is 2. And the answer that we get after subtraction is called the difference. What is it called? It is called the difference. The answer that we get after subtraction is called difference. Okay, so subtraction is the process of taking away a number or a quantity from a given number or quantity. Okay. So while doing subtraction, there are some points to be kept in mind. Okay. The first point is that we always subtract a smaller number from bigger number. We always subtract smaller number from bigger number. So look here. Here we have got 2 numbers, 18 and 28. Okay, so here which is the bigger number? 28 is the bigger number. 28 is greater than 18. So during subtraction, how we are writing this one? We have to subtract smaller number from the bigger number and we write it as 28 minus 18. We can always subtract a smaller number from a bigger number and we are writing it as 28 minus 18. Okay, the bigger number should come first and then the smaller number. And how we are reading it? 18 is subtracted from 28. 28 minus 18. This means that we are taking away 18 from 28. Okay, and also the change of order is not possible. We cannot subtract a bigger number from a smaller number. We cannot write like this. This is not possible. 18 minus 28. Change of order is not possible in subtraction. Okay. So now let's move on to the subtraction of 4-digit numbers without regrouping. Okay. Here we are given 2 numbers, 6490 and 4020, and we have to subtract these two. So for that, I have arranged it in a place value chart. Both are 4-digit numbers. So it has got the places from ones, tens, hundreds and thousands. It has got 4 places and the numbers are written according to the place values. Okay, so we are starting, always we are starting the operations from the ones place. So we have to do our operation from ones place. So in ones place the digits are 0 and 0. So 0 minus 0 gives 0 itself. 0 minus 0 is 0 itself. Then moving on to the tens place, it is 9 and 2. So we have to take away 2 from 9. Taking away 2 from 9, how much we will get? Taking away 2 from 9, it is 7. Okay, 7. So 9 minus 2 is 7. Okay, then in hundreds place, the digits are 4 and 0. 4 minus 0, taking away 0 from 4, what is left behind? 4 itself will be there. So 4 minus 0 is 4 itself. And then in thousands place, it's 6 and 4, 6 minus 4. That is, we are taking away 4 from 6. Taking away 4 from 6, what we will get? We will get 2. When we are taking away 4 from 6, it will be 2. Okay, so we got the answer as 2470. And the answer that we get in subtraction is got the difference. So here the difference is 2470. Okay, moving on to our next question. Here the numbers are 8523 and 4312. We have to subtract these two numbers. So that we have arranged it in our place value according to the places the digits are arranged. And in ones place, it's the digits are 3 and 2. So starting from the ones place, we have to subtract 3 minus 2. Okay, on taking away 2 from 3, taking away 2 from 3, we will get 1. Okay, so 3 minus 2 is 1. Then in tens place, the digits are 2 and 1. So 2 minus 1, 2 minus 1, we will get 1 itself. So taking away 1 from 2, it will make 1. Okay, and now in hundreds place, it's 5 and 3. 5 minus 3, 5 minus 3 is, taking away 3 from 5, we will get 2. So 5 minus 3 is 2. Okay, and in thousands place, it's 8 and 4. So 8 minus 4, 8 minus 4 makes 4 itself. So our answer is 4211. Okay, and the answer that we get in subtraction is called the difference. So here the difference is 4211. Okay, so today in this class we studied the subtraction of 4-digit numbers without regrouping. Okay, hope you understood how to subtract 4-digit numbers. Now you have to do a small homework in exercise 1, question number 1, C and D. The questions C and D that you have to do as your homework. Okay, thank you.